arriving in our WWF studios on a snowy New England night. Yes, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Get the hell out of here.
And it seems as though Mr. Austin is in a foul mood, much like the hitman Bret Hart.
Moses.
And we have, well, we have, we're supposed to have
he's here.
Stone Cold Steve Austin. We have a camera locked off. And unfortunately, Mr. Austin is, he was here earlier on. And we expect to talk with, well, I guess we have an audio key open somewhere.
I guess we know where he is.
Yeah, in any event, we apologize for that. We are back in Berlin. There he is. Mr. Austin, earlier on, we came to you. We missed you. We could hear something going on, but unfortunately, you were unavailable.
You could hear something going on for good reason. Do you know where the number one talent in professional wrestling was sitting on his way to Stamford, Connecticut today? He was sitting in seat 38C. Do you know where seat 38C is? It's right next to the airplane outhouse. Do you know what the number one piece of wrestling talent had for lunch today? It was a little stale sandwich stuffed in a brown paper bag. Now, I'd like to say that's what made me sick, but that's not the case. It's seeing Bret Hart whine and cry every time he gets on the WWF TV, and it makes me violently ill to my stomach. If he ain't whining, he's quitting. If he ain't quitting, he's doing something else. It ain't nothing good, and it just makes me sick.
Well, we will hear
I'd like, no, shut up. I'd like to tell you that I was indeed throwing up everywhere, but it goes a little beyond that.
All right.
Way beyond.
In any event, we will come to you a little bit later on.
Yeah, you're going to come to me because you got no choice. Someone's going to get the lights knocked out tonight.
All right, thank you very much.
For your pingle.
And plus, ladies and gentlemen, joining us live back in America. Yes, Stone Cold Steve Austin will get to you in just a moment. You talk about hot action, you got to be talking about La Femme Nikita that comes up right. What's the matter? In our WWF studios, Stone Cold Steve Austin. Mr. Austin, of course, it was at the Final Four in which you attempted to prevent Bret Hart from becoming World Wrestling Federation champion, as we are looking at footage now. Again, it seems as though you've been a thorn in Bret Hart's side ever since he returned to the World Wrestling Federation, and certainly this night was no exception. The Final Four in which you attempted to prevent him from becoming World Wrestling Federation champion. Nonetheless, the Hitman became the WWF title holder for the fourth occasion. However, the very next night, in a matchup with Psycho Sid. Again, we take you back to the footage. What is it with you? Here, submission hold apply. Yes, the Hitman Bret Hart with his patented maneuver. The sharpshooter, and look at this. The chair coming down right in the back of the head. Behind the official's back, behind Psycho Sid's back, and then, of course, the powerbomb. One like we saw earlier on, the cover, the count, and Sid became champion, partially due to you. Your response, do you show any remorse whatsoever for your action?
The only remorse I got is that I didn't hit him harder with that steel chair. Bret Hart runs around talking about everybody screwing him. Hell, for the past 7 years, I've been screwed, and it's the same old song. How come when Shawn Michaels hurts his knee, you make a video out of him? How come when Shawn Michaels gets sick, you tell the world that he's got the flu? Well, when I went to the Final Four, I was sick as a dog, and I had a blowed-out knee. Let me ask you a question. How many one-legged people could go 25 minutes with three of the top wrestlers in the world? Well, none. Stone Cold Steve Austin went out there and did just that. And I ain't making fun of no one-legged people. I'm sitting here just trying to make a point. As far as I'm concerned, I truly am the World Wrestling Federation champion, and can't nobody tell me different. Not you or anybody. As far as a submission match, it's a bunch of bull. Bret Hart, he's supposed to be the big technician, the sharpshooter. Big deal. I don't know a whole lot of a couple of submission moves, but it doesn't matter because I'll beat the hell out of Bret Hart. And as far as Ken Shamrock says on TV the other day, oh, I don't know. Bret Hart's a better technician, but Stone Cold ain't got no quit in him. Well, you hit the nail right on the head, son, because I ain't got no quit in me at all. And you can bet your bottom dollar that Stone Cold ain't gonna look at the referee and say, I quit. I submit. I've had too much. There ain't nobody in wrestling who can make me quit. And that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.
Why have all this? Why are you so bitter? Why this bitterness?
You treat me like a dog and you expect me to smile? You remind me of a jackass.